Many people feel like they're stuck in this rat race where you're going to work every single day just to earn money to pay your bills and you never have the chance to build any wealth for yourself. Well, in this video, I'm going to be going over how you can escape this rat race step by step. What's up everybody, I'm Jaspreet Singh from TheMinorityMindset.com where money minds rethink rich. Most of us are not taught about financial education and money when we're young. What happens is most of us go to school for the first 17 or 18 years of our lives and then when we're 17 or 18, we say we want to become successful. And the way that you become successful is by going to college like everybody else. And so now you go to college, except college is expensive. And so now when you're 17 or 18 years old, you sign a piece of paper saying that you're signing yourself up for an unlimited amount of student loans. And you don't really know what that means because you don't know how to manage debt. You don't know what debt is. You don't know how to really value a dollar because you haven't earned a dollar. And so now you go to college, you're having a lot of fun. And now you're 21 years old, you graduate college, you got $50,000 worth of student loans. And now it's time for you to get a job. Now you got your first job so you can finally start making money to pay off your education to get your job. But in order for you to get to and from work, you need a car. And so you go to the car dealership and they say that you can buy this $3,000 car, which you might be able to afford with cash, assuming that you have a little bit of money left over. But if you don't want to buy this $3,000 beat up car, you can go over to the BMW dealership because now you got a brand new job and now you can finance a brand new 4 Series. You worked really hard to get this job, but now it's time to finally start enjoying your life. So now you start working and now you're using a lot of your paycheck to pay off your student loans and to pay off your car. And that's when you meet somebody at work and you start to like him or her and now you decide to get married. Now you gotta pay for your wedding. You kept telling yourself that you were gonna save more money and start investing your money, but things keep coming up. You got your car payment, you got your student loan payment, you gotta pay a rent payment, and now you gotta start paying for this wedding. And every time you got a little bit of cash, your friends wanna go on a vacation. And so your money keeps disappearing and you keep trying to save some money, you keep trying to invest some money, but every time you got some cash, something comes up. Well, now you get married and now you and your spouse want to settle down and you got to go out and buy a home. But in order for you to buy a home, you need to save up for a down payment. So now you take the rest of your savings and use it to finally buy a home, which you think is an investment. So now you finally own a home and now you can finally settle down. Now you can finally start saving money and you can finally start investing money. Well, I guess not just yet, because now that you're married, you and your spouse want to go on a honeymoon. You want to go on a few trips with your friends. You want to go out on nice dinners. And so now you thought you'd finally have some more money because you have two incomes working in the same household, but you have more expenses. You got to go out to more dinners. You got to go on more vacations. You got to go on more trips. Now a couple years go by and you finally are starting to settle down and really get into the swing of married life. And now you really want to start saving money and you want to start investing money. That way you can build your wealth and stop working so hard at your job because you feel like you're just kind of like running around in this wheel. You keep making money and spending money and making money and spending money. And now you got a little bit of credit card debt piled up too because you keep going on all these trips and your friends keep getting married and you have to keep buying everybody these gifts and you didn't have the cash to do that. So you just put it on your credit card and a few other nice things that you wanted for yourself and your spouse. So now you got a little bit of credit card debt, you got your car loans, you got your student loans, you got your mortgage payment, but now you're finally ready to buckle down, save some money, invest some money, and build your wealth. Oops. You just had a baby. Now your expenses have shot back up and you have no idea how you can escape this rat race where you're constantly working to pay all your bills. You're working to pay off your expenses and you feel like you have nothing left for yourself. That's why in this video, I'm gonna be going over 3 things that you need to do if you wanna escape this rat race. But before I get into that, I need you to do me a quick favor and smash that thumbs up button below. The first thing you wanna do if you wanna break out of the system is you gotta stop living poor. And when I say poor, I don't mean physically, like I don't have any money poor, I mean mentally, like I have a poor mindset poor. This one might not seem that important, but if you do not have the right mindset, it will be impossible. It will be impossible for you to ever build wealth because you don't believe it's possible for you. I mean, if you don't believe that you can do something, you are not gonna be able to do it. It is going to be very hard for you to break out of this rat race if you are lazy and if you keep complaining instead of finding the opportunities in the world. There are so many opportunities around us, especially if you live in a first world country and if you have the means and the ability to understand what I'm saying. If you have a screen, a computer, a phone, and you can understand what I'm saying, you are blessed. You have everything that you need in order to become successful and you gotta stop complaining about what you don't have. If you keep complaining and you keep finding negativity and the problems with everything around you, you are never gonna find the opportunity that's around you. The biggest disability that you can have is a poor mindset because a poor mindset will stop you from achieving anything. Look, my grandparents were refugees in a state in India called Punjab. When our home state Punjab was severed by the government, my grandparents literally lost everything. They lost their homes, they lost their family, they lost their friends, they lost their money, and they had to literally run to a brand new home with nothing except the clothes on their back and a sword in their hand. By the time my grandfather made it across the border, he didn't even have shoes. He lost his shoes along the way, and he did not have the opportunity to take days off, because if you took a day off, you would be killed. My parents are immigrants. They came to this country with next to nothing. My dad had less than $100 in his pocket. They didn't speak English. They didn't know the people. They didn't know the culture. They didn't know how the system worked in America, but they made it work. My dad used to always tell me that there was no such thing as sick days, because if you take a sick day, you're not working. If you're not working, you don't get paid. If you don't get paid, you don't have money to eat. America is a land of opportunity. People will literally risk their lives to come to this country, and yet you have people in this country that are complacent, that are just comfortable, and then they have the opportunity to complain about what they have because they don't realize how good they have it. This is one of the reasons why I call our channel Minority Mindset, because all success starts with their mindset. If you do not have a good mindset, if you don't have a positive and a forward-thinking mindset, you will never have the opportunity or a chance to become successful, because your mind has already shut down your success. So if you have a poor mindset, that's the very first thing you gotta work on. If you do not have a good mindset, you will never have the opportunity to build wealth or escape the rat race. The second thing you gotta do is you gotta stop living a fake rich lifestyle. Here's the thing: your cars, your shoes, your clothes, your purses, your vacations, your dinners out. None of these things make you rich. None of these things are putting money in your pocket. They look cool, they make all of your friends jealous of you, and they look nice on social media, but none of these things are making you rich. All of these things are making everybody around you rich, but none of these things are putting money in your pocket. So before you start making everybody else rich, I want you to make yourself rich first. Look, I'm not saying you shouldn't go out to eat, and I'm not saying that you shouldn't go on vacation, but if you don't have any savings, and if you don't have any investments to your name, is it really worth it for you to go out and spend $3,000 to go on a 4-day vacation to the Bahamas? This is the time where you really gotta figure out what's important to you and what sacrifices you're willing to make. I used to tell all of my friends that I'm not gonna go on a vacation unless I get paid to go on vacation, because I used to work with a bunch of different DJs, and I don't want to spend money traveling, because I was so focused on using every penny that I could into my investments and into my savings so I can build my own wealth. But I did get to travel, because sometimes we would get booked to fly out to a different city or a different state and go perform over there. I think it was Dave Ramsey that first came up with this phrase, but you gotta act your wage. If you cannot afford it, if you don't have the money to do it, stop blowing your money and then complaining about why you're not wealthy. How many people do you know that are going on nice vacations, that have a nice home, that drive nice cars, that have Apple AirPods, that wear Lululemon leggings, that buy extra guac when they go to Chipotle, that also complain about how they don't have any money? A lot. All this stuff and all these things make you look rich, but they keep you broke. What I want you to do is I first want you to be actually rich, and then once you're actually rich, then you can afford all these things and not worry about the price, because you're actually rich. I want you to live in a nice home and drive a nice car and have nice things and go on nice vacations. I just want you to be able to afford it first. And one of the easiest ways to understand if you can afford something or not is just to follow our rule of five, which says if you cannot buy five of them, you cannot afford one of them. What that means now is if you want to buy something that you do not need to survive, you got to make sure you can afford it. And how do you know if you can afford it? Well, just check the rule of five. This brings me to the third thing that you got to do if you want to escape the rat race. But before I get into what this is, I want to let you know that if you are interested in learning more about money management and investing, our team has put together an amazing PDF that walks you through how to manage your money the right way, financial education, and how to invest your money to build your wealth. If you want to read this guide, it is completely free when you sign up for our daily newsletter, and I got the link to how you can download our guide and read it for free in the description below. Now, the third thing that you got to do if you want to escape the rat race is you got to start living like wealthy people. The thing that wealthy people understand is that you cannot become wealthy just through your hard work. Hard work is important, but you have to understand how to use your hard work to also work smart. You, me, and everybody else in the world only have 24 hours in a day. And none of us can work all 24 hours. And so we have to be smart. If we all are given 24 hours, how can you get the most value out of your 24 hours? And how can you start extracting more value even without you physically working? This is what wealthy people have worked to master, and this is what you need to be figuring out yourself too. See, what all wealthy people understand is that there's two different kinds of money. You have active money, and then you have passive money. Active money is the money that you earn from going to your job or from running your business. This is the money that you have to physically work to earn. Passive money is the money that you do not have to work to earn. This is the money that your money is working to earn. And so what wealthy people do is they work hard here. They work hard to generate this active money, and anytime they generate this active money from their job or their business or whatever, they want to take as much of this active money and put it here. That way they have more money working to earn them money passively. That way now you have time on your side, because the thing that wealthy people have is time. You have the ability to live your life the way you want because your money is working hard to pay all of your bills and buy the things that you want. This is what differentiates a broke person from a wealthy person, because a broke person lives here. They make money from their job or their business, and this is what they use to spend and enjoy their life. And as soon as they stop working, they stop making money, and now they don't have money to afford their lifestyle. What wealthy people do is they make money here, and they take as much money here and put it here, and then they live off of whatever money their money generates, and so they can put as much money here into here, and now they can enjoy the life because they are going to continue getting paid even if they stop working. This is what it means to be wealthy and escape the rat race, because now you don't have to be physically working to pay your bills. Your money is working to pay your bills and to fund your lifestyle, and now you can do what you want and you can do something that you enjoy. But the only way that you can make this happen is if you remember the first two things that I talk about. First, you gotta stop living like you're poor. You have to have the right mindset, and you have to believe that this is possible for you, because the first thing that everybody says is, oh, that's easy for you to say, or oh, that's not possible for somebody like me. If you tell yourself it's not possible, yeah, you're right, it is going to be impossible for you. But if you believe that it's possible for you, you're gonna figure out how you can do it, and you're gonna put the steps into action to actually make it happen. The second thing you gotta do is you gotta stop living the fake rich lifestyle, because if you have no money to put here, you're not gonna be able to create any income here. So the next thing you gotta do after you have the right mindset is you gotta stop blowing all of your money on things that you don't need. You might have to downsize for a little bit. You might have to say goodbye to your BMW for a little bit. You might have to put your vacations on pause for a little bit. That way you have more money here to put here. Because if all of your money that you're working to earn is going out to pay your bills and to fund this extravagant lifestyle, or even if it's not extravagant, to fund your lifestyle, then you're gonna have no money here. So the first thing you gotta do is you gotta cut your expenses. That way you have more money to put here. The second thing that you wanna do is, now that you understand how to use your money, is you wanna start attracting more money so you have more money to put here. Now, the ways that you can earn more money is maybe by asking for a raise, working to earn a promotion, trying to start a side hustle, starting a side business. These things might take more work, but now as you're attracting more money, you can get the most benefit from your money, because now you know how to put your money to work. You can put more money towards your investments and to things that are gonna pay you for owning them. So now it's not just you working to fund your lifestyle and pay all your bills. Now it's your money working to pay your bills, and you're working just to keep funding more investments. So now the question is, where do you actually put your money so your money's growing? Well, one place that you want to put your money is into your own education, because you got to understand how to actually use your money. And this might mean reading books, buying courses, taking seminars, learning how to use your money the right way. That way you can start generating more income. Second place might be in stocks or real estate. Both stocks and real estate, and when I talk about real estate, I mean rental properties. Both stocks and real estate, you're buying for the sole purpose of making money. When you're spending money here to buy shoes, to buy clothes, to buy vacations, none of these things you're buying to make money, because as soon as you buy a new pair of shoes, or as soon as you go on a vacation, you don't expect to get any money back. You're buying these things to use and consume. Now, that's not a problem if you can afford it, but if you can't afford it because you have no money coming in here, that's a problem. And so when we talk about buying things here, stocks, real estate, education. Now, the reason why you're buying these things is to make you more money. So it's a different mindset, and you have to put more money here if you want to be able to live a bigger lifestyle, because now you have more money working hard to earn you more money. We have tons of videos on our channel where I go over in more depth on how to actually invest your money and grow your money, which is why if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, make sure you do that. If you enjoyed this video, here's an in-depth video guide that will walk you through how to build wealth. And while you're at it, download our free money management PDF. And as always, keep hustling. You really just gotta find the right risk balance for you, because anytime you pull a dollar out, that's a dollar that you cannot compound. But if you keep the dollars in there, then you take on more risk. I mean, this is one of the things that made Elon Musk so financially successful,